सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन टुडेस सेशन गाइस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नाबार्ड। तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं आज का सेशन। लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल। वन सेकेंड, या डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions and also about the course. So let's begin with the very first question guys, which is about the black fungus, jiska naam aapne aajkal kafi zyada news mein suna hoga. So you have to consider the following statement regarding mucormycosis, or you can say the black fungus, isi ka naam black fungus hai, and you have to identify the correct statements regarding this mucormycosis. So let's talk about this mucormycosis, which is also known as black fungus. So what is this mucormycosis? So guys, remember it is a disease which is caused by a set of microorganism, which is caused by a set of fungus, which is known as mucormycetes. Mucormycetes is the name of fungus, jo ki iska causative organism hai. And this fungus, mucormycetes, is present naturally in the environment, and it can be seen mostly in the soil and decaying organic matter like leaves, compost and piles. सो बेसिकली ये जो फंगस होता है म्यूकोरमाइसेट्स, ये कहाँ पे होता है? हमारे एनवायरनमेंट में प्रेजेंट है, हमारे एनवायरनमेंट में ये प्रेजेंट है, और ज्यादातर ये कहाँ पे देखा जाता है? सॉइल में, और इसके अलावा ऐसे ऑर्गेनिक मैटर में जो कि डीके हो रहे हैं, जैसे कि सूखे पत्ते हो गए, कंपोस्ट हो गए, इस तरीके की चीजें। ऑलराइट, नाउ व्हाट आर द कॉजेज ऑफ म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस? सबसे पहला कॉज तो वो हमने फंगस पढ़ लिया, म्यूकोरमाइसेटिस वो उसका कॉज है, एंड पीपल कॉज दिस disease by coming in contact with the fungal spores in the environment, which means the fungal spores are the carriers. The fungal spores are the carriers of that fungus. Okay, and it can also develop on the skin after the fungus enters the skin through a cut, through a scrape, through a burn, or through other type of skin infection. किसी भी तरीके का skin trauma है हुआ है, किसी भी तरीके का cut लगा है, किसी भी तरीके का burn हुआ है skin के आसपास, तो वहाँ पे उसके थ्रू जो फंगस है म्यूकोरमाइसेटिस वो एंटर कर सकता है। राइट, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द पेशेंट्स हु आर एट रिस्क। सो रिमेंबर इट इज मोस्टली डिटेक्टेड इन डायबिटिक पेशेंट्स। सबसे ज्यादा किस में ये डिटेक्ट हुआ है? डायबिटिक पेशेंट में। सो द डायबिटिक पेशेंट्स आर मोर प्रोन टू दिस डिजीज, एंड ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द एडवाइजरी इश्यूड बाय ICMR, सम पेशेंट्स हु हैव दीज कंडीशंस आर एट द रिस्क। For example, the patients who have uncontrolled diabetes, the patients whose immune system is weak due to the use of steroids during COVID-19 infection, due to prolonged ICU or hospital stay during COVID infection, comorbidities, post-organ transplant, or a patient having cancer, and this therapy which is used to treat serious fungal infection, which is known as voriconazole therapy. Right? So these, agar kisi patient ke paas ye condition hai, so that patient is more prone to this disease, right? Now, what is the relation of black fungus with COVID-19 patient? Why mucormycosis जो है वो COVID-19 patient को affect कर रहा है? इसका reason क्या है? तो guys, reason बहुत simple है, because in the normal course our body's immune system successfully fights against this fungal infection. जब हम ठीक होते हैं, जब हम बीमार नहीं होते हैं, तो जो हमारी body की immune system होती है, वो इसको fight इससे against fight कर लेती है. But during the COVID-19 infection, what coronavirus does? So it affects our immune system and weaken it. जो हमारे immune system है वो उसको weak कर देता है और उसको affect करता है बहुत बुरी तरीके से, and due to which some COVID patients fail the battle against this attacks by the fungus. Okay, तो जो कुछ COVID patients ऐसे होते हैं जिनका immune system बहुत ज़्यादा weak हो जाता है, some patients are there which have जिनका कोविड की वजह से बहुत ज्यादा वीक इम्यून सिस्टम हो जाता है, उनके इम्यून सिस्टम पे अटैक करना बहुत इजी हो जाता है बाय दिस फंगस। राइट, एंड इन एडिशन टू दिस कोविड पेशेंट्स हु आर अंडरगोइंग ऑक्सीजन थेरेपी वेयर ह्यूमिडिफायर इज यूज्ड, सो विद द यूज ऑफ ह्यूमिडिफायर द चांसेस ऑफ अटैक ऑफ दिस फंगस इंक्रीजेस। ओके, ह्यूमिडिफायर की वजह से एक्सपोजर टू मॉइस्चर होता है, और मॉइस्चर में जो फंगल स्पोर्स है उनकी ग्रोथ बहुत तेजी से होती है। राइट, सो इट फंगल स्पोर्स के लिए बेसिकली एक अच्छी कंडीशन होती है टू ग्रो। कैसी कंडीशन? मॉइस्चर वाली। ओके, सो ह्यूमिडिफायर की वजह से मॉइस्चर इंक्रीज हो जाता है, एंड उसकी वजह से जो चांसेस ऑफ इन्फेक्शन है ऑफ दिस डिजीज इंक्रीज हो जाते हैं। राइट, नाउ व्हाट आर द कॉमन सिम्टम्स? सो स्किन इन्फेक्शन इन द एयर पॉकेट्स लोकेटेड बिहाइंड अवर फॉरहेड, nose, cheekbones and between the eyes and teeth. Iske alawa it then spread to eyes, lungs and can even spread to the brain. And remember, it can also lead to blackening or discoloration over the nose, blurred or double vision, chest pain ho sakta hai, breathing difficulties and coughing of blood. So basically, इनमें से अगर कोई भी सिम्टम आपके आसपास किसी को दिखाई देता है तो प्लीज उनको बताएं, क्योंकि कई लोग हैं जिनके जिनको इन चीजों के बारे में नहीं पता होगा. मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल आर नॉट अवेयर ऑफ दिस डिजीज. सो इफ यू फाइंड एनी पर्सन विद दीज सिम्टम्स अराउंड यू, सो प्लीज उनको बताएं एंड टेल देम टू गो टू द हॉस्पिटल. खुद खलीफा नहीं बनना है. ऑलराइट, ट्रीटमेंट कैसा होता है, प्रिकॉशंस क्या क्या लिए जा सकते हैं. सो ट्रीटमेंट इन्वॉल्व सर्जिकली रिमूविंग ऑल द डेड एंड इन्फेक्टेड टिश्यू. द टिश्यू which are infected, which have been infected by this fungus will have to be removed. Then cure may also involve a 4 to 6 week course of intravenous antifungal therapy होती है, वो 4 से 6 हफ्ते की होती है if the infection is mild. And also talking about the precautions, so we have to control the diabetes, use steroid judiciously. अगर डॉक्टर ने नहीं बोला है तो steroids नहीं लेने हैं during the COVID infection. Keep good hygiene, don't self-medicate or ऑफकोर्स सेल्फ मेडिकेट नहीं करना, खुद से खलीफा नहीं बनना है. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द प्रिकॉशंस दैट कैन बी टेकन बाय द कोविड 19 पेशेंट्स इफ दे वांट टू अवॉइड दिस फंगल इन्फेक्शन. ओके, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस ब्लैक फंगस. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट हियर. द डिजीज इज कॉज्ड बाय म्यूकरमाइसाइटिस. यस, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. द कैरियर्स ऑफ दिस डिजीज आर फंगल स्पोर्स प्रेजेंट इन द एनवायरनमेंट. यस, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. And use of humidifier decreases the chances of infection. No, it in fact increases the chances of infection because moisture is one of the better condition for fungal spores to grow. So therefore, this statement is incorrect and hence the correct statement, guys, will be option B, only 1 and 2. Okay. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. Ministry of Tribal Affairs, which is headed by Shri Arjun Singh Munda. Shri Arjun Singh Munda, his Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti, which is in Jharkhand, and Dash signed an MOU on joint initiative for digital transformation of tribal schools. Jo tribal schools hain unke digital transformation ke liye joint initiative ke liye ek MOU signed hua hai between Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Dash. So you have to fill this gap. So guys, the company is Microsoft. Microsoft and Ministry of Tribal Affairs have signed this MOU for digital transformation of tribal schools, and this MOU will support the digital transformation of schools such as Eklavya Modern Residential Schools and Ashram School among others under the ministry. Jo schools ministry ke andar aate hain, Ministry of Tribal Affairs of course unhi schools ki baat karega which are there for the tribals. So one example is Eklavya Modern Residential School and another example is Ashram School. So if any other school that comes under the ministry, uska digital transformation kiya jayega. Okay. Now these are some things that will be done under this MOU. These are not important for the exam. You don't have to remember. This is just for the basic understanding ki is MOU ke andar kya kya cheeze hongi. So Microsoft will make AI curriculum available in both the languages of English and Hindi at all the Eklavya Model Residential Schools to skill the educators and students in the next gen technologies. In the first phase, 250 EMRS schools have been adopted by Microsoft, and out of these 250, EMRS schools will be given intensive training. 250 में से 50 को intensive training दी जाएगी and 500 master trainers would be trained in the first phase. Then the program will also offer opportunities for teacher to earn professional e-badges and e-certificate in return of their training. And these schools will be equipped with the technology, training and tools required to transform them into Microsoft Showcase schools. Okay. So these are some of the things that will be done under this MOU, and therefore guys, the correct answer should be what, option B, Microsoft, Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Microsoft have signed this MOU. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Indian Navy hosted, now who is the chief of Indian Navy, please write down in the comments. You have to tell me the name of chief of Indian Navy. Indian Navy hosted GMS 21 under the aegis of Naval War College, Goa. The GMS was conceptualized and first held in which year? So what is this GMS first of all? It is Goa Maritime Symposium, and remember it was first conceptualized and held in the year 2016. Now what is the purpose of this symposium? It is for fostering friendly relation with the maritime neighbors of India. Jo hamare desh ke aaspaas ke neighbors hai, maritime neighbors hai, unke saath friendly relations ko foster karne ke liye ye symposium kiya jata hai, and this was for the first time that it was hosted in the virtual mode. Sabse pehli baar aisa tha, of course कोविड की वजह से, कि ये वर्चुअल मोड में कंडक्ट कराया गया। नाउ विच कंट्रीज पार्टिसिपेटेड, सो इट इंक्लूड्स इंडिया, बांग्लादेश, कोमोरोस, इंडोनेशिया, मेडागास्कर, मलेशिया, मालदीव्स, मॉरिशियस, म्यांमार, सेशल्स, सिंगापुर, श्रीलंका एंड थाईलैंड। ऑफ कोर्स यू नीड नॉट रिमेंबर ऑल द नेम्स। एंड व्हाट वाज द थीम? इट वाज मैरीटाइम सिक्योरिटी एंड इमर्जिंग नॉन ट्रेडिशनल थ्रेट्स, अ केस फॉर प्रोएक्टिव रोल फॉर आईओआर नेवीज। आईओआर मींस इंडियन ओशन रीजन, राइट? सो थीम आपको याद रखनी जरूरी है। ऑफ कोर्स पूरा याद मत रखो, कुछ कीवर्ड्स याद रख लो, उससे आपको एग्जाम में क्लिक हो जाएगा। एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन। सो इट वाज फर्स्ट कंसेप्चुलाइज्ड एंड हेल्ड इन द ईयर 2016, guys, which means option A will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. It's, guys, a very important question. It is about a telecounseling service which is known as Samvedna. So it is a telecounseling service provided through a network of qualified doctors and professionals. Question is, what is the purpose of Samvedna? ये किसको telecounseling service provide करने के लिए है? Okay, to whom? This telecounseling service is for whom? So the question is this, okay? So now let's talk about this. So National Commission for Protection of Child Right is providing this service, telecounseling service, to the children through Samvedna. Now what is the full form of Samvedna? It's sensitizing action on mental health vulnerability through emotional development and necessary acceptance. बहुत लंबी चौड़ी formula full form है, but कोई बात नहीं, याद हो जाएगा, बार बार याद करो, keep on revising, हो जाएगा. Now this telecounseling service is for psychological support to the children to address their stress, anxiety, fear and other issues during the pandemic. So guys, we all know that during the pandemic the cases of stress, anxiety, fear keeps on increasing. Bahut sare cases hamare aas pass. So to control that among the children, this Samvedna telecounseling service have been started by National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, right? And it will be provided through a network of, actually it is being provided, it was started in the year 2020 only. September 2020 में ही ये शुरू हो चुका था. It is being provided through a network of qualified expert counselors or psychologists. And this has been done through a toll-free number which is 1800-121-2830. And there are three categories of children to whom this telecounseling service is being provided. Number one, children who are in quarantine or isolation or COVID care centers. Number two, children who have COVID positive parents or family members or the near or dear ones. Children who have lost their parents due to COVID-19 pandemic. So these three categories ke children ko this telecounseling service is being provided by through this service which is known as Samvedna. Okay. So now what is the purpose of Samvedna? It is to provide telecounseling to children during COVID-19 pandemic. So option E, guys, will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to the last question, question number 5, which is about the deaths of elephants. So a lot of elephants, that is 186 elephants were killed after, in fact, were died, not killed. Ab isme died kahenge ya killed kahenge beta, ye thoda sa ye jo hai ye judicial ho jayega thoda sa, aur thoda sa legal ho jayega ki ab kisi log ko pilot ne janbujh ke uda diya ya fir galti se uda. So this is, you know, quite controversial. So let's talk, so isme hum died ki baat karte hain. Were died after being hit by trains across India between 2009-10 and 2020-21. Which state accounted for the highest number of elephant casualties? So, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Now, how this is related to ASI, guys? It is from the environmental economics. Okay, this is from the environmental economics. So, this is how it is related to the ASI syllabus, right? So, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is saying that a total of 186 elephants were killed after being hit by the trains in the last 10 years between the financial year 2010 to the financial year 2021. And Assam accounted for the highest number of elephant casualties on the railway tracks, followed by West Bengal and Odisha. Number 2 pe it was West Bengal and number 2 pe it was Odisha. Number 3 pe it was Odisha. And Uttar Pradesh saw a single death. There was only one death of elephant during this human-animal conflict in Uttar Pradesh. A permanent coordination committee has been constituted now between the Ministry of Railways and the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change to curb these incidents. And there are some other measures that have been taken by the ministries, like clearing vegetation along the railway tracks taki jo loco pilot hai usko clearly visible ho cheeze, construction of underpass or overpass for the safe passage of elephants, regular patrolling of vulnerable stretches of railway tracks, warning sign boards, etc. So, talking about the fund released. So, for the last since the last 10 years 2011-12 to the financial year 2020-21, the ministry has released around 212 crores for protecting elephants from the trains. But कुछ खास अभी हमने काफी प्रोग्रेस किया है इन दिस एरिया, बट अ लॉट नीड्स टू बी डन. राइट, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. विच स्टेट अकाउंटेड फॉर द हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ एलिफेंट कैजुअल्टी? इट्स असम. नंबर वन पे असम है, नंबर टू पे वी हैव वेस्ट बंगाल, एंड नंबर थ्री पे वी हैव उड़ीसा. ऑलराइट, एंड इन यूपी वी हैव ओनली वन, वी हैव सिंगल डेथ ऑफ एलिफेंट ड्यू टू दिस ह्यूमन एनिमल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. ऑप्शन बी हियर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड गाइस, दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन टुडे. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. मिलते हैं Friday के session में. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.